What is up, YouTube? Hope you guys are doing fine on this cloudy Sunday. It's been a very busy week. I was working and having productions here in Cologne, planning for the next weeks as well. But I'm very grateful and stay tuned for more videos in the next weeks. As you guys know, every Sunday there will be a new video on my channel. Very happy about the feedback so far. I've started uploading like 5 weeks ago or so, and like I already see some improvements and some new followers. Thank you so much in the first place. And yeah, today's video will be about me shooting in Saxon, Switzerland. Some of you guys might have seen on my Instagram that I was in Saxon, Switzerland, which is Sächsische Schweiz in German, or maybe even Sexy Schweiz, that's what we call it, in Leipzig. Yeah, and all I can say is that it's incredibly beautiful. Like, I've lived in Leipzig for like half a year, maybe even 1 year, and I never made it to Saxon, Switzerland. And honestly, like, I have some regrets because I've been there once now, and I wish I've been there before because it's like, it's insanely beautiful. I've never seen anything like it, and it's, I don't know, like, you should go there. Like, definitely during these weird times where we're not able to travel like to other countries, if we have a weekend off or so, just go for a road trip to Saxon, Switzerland. It's located in the eastern part of Germany, like 2 hours drive from Leipzig, or I think 1 hour from Dresden, close to the Czech border. National Park Saxon, Switzerland, highly recommended. I definitely will go there again because like we've spent the whole Sunday wandering in this place, and we drove there from Leipzig at like 3 a.m. in the morning, 2 hours drive to catch sunrise. We didn't make it on time, but luckily we had some sun during the whole day, so that was very beautiful. Super windy, you will see that in the pictures, but honestly, you should go there, no doubt about it. Like, one of the most beautiful places I've seen in Germany so far, hands down. All of the pictures you see in this video are shot on my Leica M6 on the Amaroid 28 2.8, the only lens I own for my Leica M6. But maybe there will be some more lenses in the future. I'm looking forward to buy a 50 mil or so to get some more diversity in my upcoming portrait shootings. And everything is shot on Portra 800. And just in case you see me using this thing in the video, and you guys might wonder what this is, it is a light meter from Seconic, Flashmate LX308. And what does it do? So it's like most of the film cameras, they do have an internal light meter, so it says like what the correct exposure is due to the light meter inside the camera. But sometimes it's quite hard to measure the light correctly and to expose correctly. So this thing actually helps you doing it. So what it can do is you turn it on, and you can actually expose for the entire scene, so what your camera sees, but also you can, like, for example, when you have a portrait shooting or so, you can expose for the highlights or for the shadows very precisely. So for example, I don't know, it's set to ISO 800 right now, and if I, for example, measure the exposure right now, let's say on this side of my face, it's like at f-stop 4, it says 1/60th of a second. And if I would place it in the shadow part, so right here, this should be a bit darker. Okay, now it says 1/15th of a second. So you can very precisely point it like in shadows or in the highlights of your picture, and you can get the exact exposure that you wanna get. You can also expose for the entire scene, so this is what your camera actually does. If you just put it this way and expose, okay, now it says 1/25th, but I'm pointing like to the light, so I should do it like this. Now it says 1/60th, so this is like the all over exposure of the image, and it comes in pretty handy because it's very light, very tiny. The build quality could be better. It's made of plastic and it costs like 180 bucks, which in my opinion is a lot, but however, it works pretty fine, and therefore I'm pretty happy that I ordered it some weeks ago. And if you see it in the video, this is what I'm doing. I'm just like exposing mostly for the entire scene just to get my exposure right. Yeah, and without further ado, let's jump right into the video. I hope you guys enjoy this one. Please make sure to watch till the end. Leave your comments down below. I would be very grateful if you guys subscribe to the channel, because there will be more videos coming up in the next weeks. If you guys are interested in how like this thing works in detail, or if you guys are interested in, I don't know, having any questions or whatever is on your mind, please feel free to leave some comments down below, and I will do a Q&A in the near future. Thank you for being here today. Enjoy the video, and yeah, love you guys, and see you next week.